I mean, certainly, if as every suggestion is that he was asked to pull back from this, he was sacrificed, and the blame was placed on unnamed, unidentified, anonymous Fine Gael officials.
Yeah, as Martina says, it became aware late last night that Mr. McNulty was canvassing senior officials or senior members of Fine Gael for support. He subsequently had had a meeting with these unnamed Fine Gael officials who were being blamed for everything, at which point it became clear that he was no longer in the race for the Shannon seat. So it appears, as you said, that he was thrown under a bus. He was made the sacrificial lamb in all of this mess. And I think, you know, it is worth noting as well that the Taoiseach has blamed the senior Fine Gael officials. We need to know who those senior Fine Gael officials are, and we haven't heard from Heather Humphreys. She had two media appointments last night and this morning and didn't attend either one of them, and she hasn't spoken to the media on this issue.
Richard Boybar, as I say, today is the day that the water charges take effect. We have unemployment figures showing still unemployment stubbornly high, well over 11%. Does all of this really matter to people?
Yeah, well, I think it adds insult to injury. I mean, I think the big issue for people is the water charges, another huge burden and imposition on families that many of whom can't take any more. But then it adds insult to injury when we discover that tribal cronyism is alive and well with this government. And maybe as well as the McNulty affair and the stacking of the IMA board for political purposes, or this Sullis affair now with a neighbour of the Taoiseach's getting a job on the board of Sullis. But one that really shows how the two things connect is the former councillor in Waterford who was put onto the board of Irish Water and also was given a job driving a ministerial car in the Department of Environment.
Richard, I'm going to cut across you because the Cian Coral has just taken his seat. We're going to go over to the Dáil Chamber now, or the last Cian Coral it is, and it would be helpful if Heather Humphreys was to come into the Dáil or on radio or television or somewhere and say, look, this is what happened, and to lay the facts before people so we could have some sort of clarity.
Yeah, well, she's conspicuous by her absence in this whole debate, which is very suspicious, and the failure of the Taoiseach to directly answer the question really does seem to suggest that he played some role in pushing for the appointment to the IMA board for political purposes. That's the only explanation I can draw from his failure to answer that direct question.
Well, we know that the appointment to the Shannon was pretty clearly a political appointment. Well, it was obviously a political appointment, but it was an electoral appointment because he was a potential candidate in Donegal in the next election. That's why he got the nod.
Yeah, absolutely. But it is not acceptable that people are put on state boards dealing with areas like the Museum of Modern Art for political purposes. That's not acceptable. That is an abuse of, you know, important state agencies for political purposes, and is the sort of cronyism, quite frankly, that crashed this country in the past. I do find it quite rich, the Fianna Fáil, criticising them for it, because, of course, they packed, I think, 100 people onto state boards in the last month before they left government. But now we have Fine Gael, who promised to do things differently, doing exactly the same. It stinks absolutely to high heaven, and they've been caught, it seems to me, red-handed.
Yeah. Sarah, I mean, a couple of times the Taoiseach has said today, yesterday, let's move on to the issue of, well, Joan Collins, and I'll come to you on this, Richard Boybar, raised connected two issues, the illegal eviction, as she described it, of a family in her constituency, in contrast to the way people are being treated who are protesting against the installation of water meters and the introduction of water charges. But the Taoiseach came back with a comment, and he talked about people travelling from outside areas to go into areas to stage protests, and he said there are cases of where Irish Water people going about their business have been abused and have faced a hostile crowd. Is that happening? Are there mobile pickets or protests moving around the country to try to block the installation of water meters?
Yeah, look, I'm sure there's some elements, small groups or whatever move around, but that's not in any way representative of the big picture. I mean, last night, for example, I was at two meetings, one in Little Bray and one in Sallynoggin, and they were packed with local residents, absolutely furious. And that scale of meeting is being replicated in communities right across Dublin and right across the country. There is absolute fury about the water charges. There's a very, very significant mobilisation taking place across the country, and overwhelmingly those who are involved in the protests are people from the local communities.
Overwhelmingly, but not exclusively.
Well, of course there's campaign groups, and they're entitled, by the way, to protest.
Sure.
But the important issue, which he's not, the Taoiseach is not addressing, is that the overwhelming majority of people involved in these protests are actually from the local community themselves. Mm. Quite frankly, if it wasn't, if that wasn't the case, a small number of mobile protesters wouldn't be having any impact.
I was just going to come to Martina on this, because I mean, I've heard it said that Irish Water's policy